Good morning and welcome everybody. I am Yola Gorreia, an R&D process engineer specialized in continuous coating technology at IMA Active Division. I am with Samuele Capomasi, our continuous coater technologist, and together with VIV experts, we are going to introduce you to our webinar. Today, we are going to show you the advantages of using a PAT tool to monitor in real time the continuous coating process in CROMA coater machine. But now, before going into more details, I ask to Capomasi Samuele to give us some information regarding the functionalities of CROMA continuous coater machine.
Thank you, Yola, for your kind introduction. Good morning, everyone, and welcome also from my side. Going straight to the point, CROMA is a continuous tablet coater designed to work in a truly continuous mode. That means that the product flows seamlessly into the drum. Uncoated tablets are continuously fed into the coater, while coated tablets are continuously discharged. A constant feeding of uncoated tablets is ensured by the use of a lossing weight feeder. As spray guns are located along the drum, tablets are coated while they move inside the pan. For these reasons, tablets closest to the feeding area have a thin coating layer, which gradually increase as they move towards the last gun. Since target weight gain is achieved only after passing the whole drum, PAT probe is installed at the exit chute of the machine. The presence of baffles and anti-sliding bars ensures both a good radial mixing and an efficient axial transportation of tablets. Nonetheless, the machine is capable even of working in a semi-continuous mode, according to customers' needs. That means that with CROMA, you can even work in batch mode, and this can be useful, for example, during the development of new products. Modularity is a key word when talking about CROMA. For instance, modules can be arranged in parallel to reach higher throughputs, or in series to reach higher weight gains. This allows the maximum flexibility both in terms of machine configuration and process performances. Even though the machine is designed to be integrated in a continuous manufacturing line, CROMA coater is capable of working even as a standalone unit. Process monitoring and control are essential part when we talk about continuous manufacturing, and that is where PAT tools plays a key role. But Yola, please, could you explain us better this concept and how we implemented PAT tools on a CROMA coater?
The implementation of continuous pharmaceutical manufacturing requires advanced control strategies with different level of automation to maintain the process in a state of control and the final product quality within specification. Continuous monitoring allows the detection of process deviations and the rejection of out-of-specification material basing on the real-time process data. So, PAT, Process Analytical Technology, can be defined as a system for designing, analyzing, and controlling process manufacturing by measurement of product critical attributes to ensure quality and to reduce process variability. The implementation of a PAT system involves the insertion of a PAT probe into the process. Fast consecutive measurements provide process insight and understanding. It is necessary that a PAT probe measures in a non-destructive way, so as not to interfere with the mass flow. This calls for the use, for example, of spectral instrumentations. Today, we will show you the steps necessary to implement a PAT probe to monitor a continuous coating process in CROMA machine. First of all, it is necessary to understand and to fix which is the variable or the critical attribute to be monitored. In our case, we want to monitor in real time the weight gain of coated tablets exiting from CROMA machine. So it is necessary to assess the process robustness by monitoring continuously the weight gain of coated tablets and by ensuring the constant weight gain during the time. The second step is to select the most appropriate process analytical technology to monitor and to detect the wanted critical attribute or variable. In our case, we wanted to investigate if the NIR probe is capable to distinguish between uncoated tablets with different weight gains. So we started performing bench tests, and what we show is that the NIR spectra have a correlation between the absorbance intensity and the different coating gains of the analyzed tablets. But before going into more detail regarding the process, I ask Michał, R&D manager at Viavi Solutions, to tell us more regarding the functionalities of the NIR process analyzer.
Hello everyone, I'm very happy to be here at IMA. My name is Michał Klimek, I'm the R&D manager of MicroNIR products at Viavi Solutions. And I'm very excited to show the audience the application of MicroNIR in tablet coating continuous manufacturing. Back in 2012, with the introduction of the MicroNIR 1700, Viavi Solutions has revolutionized the market by introducing the smallest NIR instrumentation in the world, allowing direct installation of spectrometers into process environments, now also including hazardous locations often found in production environments. At the heart of the instrument is Viavi Solutions' proprietary NIR linear variable filter, or LVF, which allows operation without any moving parts, providing highly repeatable measurements, and is virtually maintenance-free. LVF is fabricated by a thin film deposition on a substrate. Linearly variable filter means that the wavelength of light passing through the filter varies along the length of the filter linearly. The filter is aligned once during the fabrication of the instrument, after which it is calibrated, ensuring that the performance of the instrument is stable for the life of the instrument. The LVF-enabled MicroNIR allows direct installation. Direct installation allows the elimination of the fiber optic cables, which greatly reduces the maintenance intervals and cost. Furthermore, by eliminating the fiber optic cables, we greatly reduce the temperature effect inherent to the fiber optic cables. Moreover, with our proprietary temperature-based normalization, we're able to guarantee a virtually stable performance to a broad temperature range, allowing great flexibility to the end user. Finally, an overlooked advantage of the LVF is high light transmission. This allows high signal-to-noise ratio with a reduced requirement for sample illumination. This allows the lamps to be run below the rated power, greatly increasing their life. In fact, in 10 years, we have not had a single instrument returned to us due to lamp wear. I would like to also provide a brief overview of triggering options for our PAT platform of devices. Depending on the model, the end user has access to a gravity trigger or a timer. In addition, some of our devices allow for an auxiliary trigger input, such as an optical trigger. Finally, to optimize the instrument integration into process environments, our software supports both OPC-DA and OPC-UA platforms. Our Pro software allows integration with several OPC-DA platforms, while our recently released Spectrum server allows integration into OPC-UA integrated facilities. We have worked closely with our partners to integrate seamless operation with Siemens SiPath and Emerson DeltaV platforms.
After selecting the most appropriate monitoring technology, in our case the MicroNIR PTU, process integration has to be planned, which involves the development, calibration, method validation, maintenance, and periodic review. After bench tests, the next step regards the determination of the best location to put the NIR probe. We determine this location in the exit chute of a CROMA continuous quarter, and we performed a lot of trials to understand which is the best position in the chute in order to be sure that the spectra acquired by the NIR probe can be useful and reproducible when the tablets flow through the exit chute. Now Samuele is going to give us more information regarding the calibration of an NIR signal.
Calibration of NIR signal is a key step to build a robust model. In order to calibrate NIR and convert spectral responses to quality values, one or more multivariate predictive models are required. At first, we selected tablet shape and the type of coating solution. Then, we started with the acquisition of raw data at different weight gains. Since in our trial the target weight gain is 4%, several batches in a range from 1 to 7% have been carried out. At the end of each batch, product is discharged through the exit chute of the machine. Meanwhile, NIR spectra are acquired continuously. Raw data are then pre-processed and a model is built. But now, Eleonora will go into more detail about a creation and a calibration of a PLS model.
Thank you, Samuele, and welcome also from my side. I'm Eleonora Mustorgi, MicroNIR Application Engineer in Viavi Solutions. And today, we'll see together how to develop a quantitative model based on NIR spectroscopy. NIR spectroscopy is one of the most applied analytical technology for process monitoring in pharmaceutical fields, allowing to obtain a global knowledge about the system of interest in a completely non-destructive way. However, the NIR spectra collected by the MicroNIR are very complex signals, characterized by broad and often overlap bands in which the chemical and the physical information is embodied. In order to extract the only useful information, it's necessary to apply specific multivariate data analysis strategies, and the MicroNIR Pro software offers a complete data analysis package for developing qualitative and quantitative models for the monitoring of continuous processes. Regarding tablets manufacturing, NIR spectroscopy coupled with chemometric techniques is a huge applied for compression, coating, and final product characterization. This approach demonstrated to be suitable for developing many different applications, such as blending, granulation, and dry monitoring, the estimation of tablet hardness, and the real-time monitoring of coating weight gain without the need to sample the tablet. In the present application, the MicroNIR PATU has been applied for monitoring the CROMA coater in order to obtain a fast and accurate prediction of the coating weight gain. In order to develop a quantitative model, the partial least square regression algorithm has been used. PLS is one of the most popular linear calibration techniques, which allows to correlate the spectral information with the quantitative property of interest. And now we'll see together two of the most important outcomes of PLS, the score plot and the reference versus predicted. The score plot allows to evaluate the distribution of the samples in an orthogonal space. In this case, it's possible to identify a clear trend in according to the increase of the weight gain of the tablets. This result allows to confirm the suitability of the MicroNIR in detecting the target information related to the weight gain of the tablets. The second plot, predicted versus reference, allows to directly compare the real values of weight gain with the estimations done by the model reported on the y-axis. For this model, it's possible to identify a very high correlation between the spectra and the property of interest, the weight gain of the tablets, close to the 100%. This high correlation ensures a very low error in the model, equal to the 0.15. Moreover, the high usability of the MicroNIR Pro software allows to obtain a straightforward interpretation of the results, making them accessible also for the unpersonal skilled.
Once it is established that the fine model fits well, process integration can be done. Given a process, it is important to define the tolerances for the percentage of weight gain that we want to monitor. If the weight gain detected by the NIR probe remains within the tolerance limits, this means that the process is going well and it is under control. If the weight gain deviates from the tolerance range, this means that a deviation occurs and that a rejection of the out-of-spec material can be done and an alarm will be on. So we can tell that the build model has been used successfully to monitor and to detect the coating weight gain during a long-run continuous coating process. Thus, it is possible to gain insights into product quality in real time without the need to use offline measurements.
Thank you for your attention. If you are interested in exploring continuous manufacturing and knowing more about the use of NIR sensor as a PAT tool, both IMA Active Laboratory and the VIAVI Expert are more than happy to support you.